Just waiting.
Hallelujah.
Praise
Praise
God.
God. Praise God. It is a gorgeous day this yes. May the 29th.
Yes, yes.
God is faithful.
Yes, he is.
Hallelujah.
We're just waiting to get started here at Healing Fire Deliverance Ministries for our Bible study. So we're just waiting a few more moments before we actually proceed. Amen. Yes. But we welcome those that are listening, that are viewing. Welcome in Jesus' name. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank
God
you,
is good. God is wonderful.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Amen. 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 Welcome. If there's someone joining us, welcome. We have exactly 2 minutes before we get started with our Bible study
yeah,
today.
Amen. Amen. And then we'll get into the Word and we pray that God would bless what He gives us to share with you and that it would be a Word that is Rhema, an in-season Word
yes.
that God would speak through us to you that would change your life. Amen.
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 Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. All right.
Okay.
We're a little hot, y'all. We're hot. Jesus. Not like healing a fire, but sweating fire.
You're right, bro.
All right. All right. Amen.
Praise God with his word.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. God, He is worthy of all honor.
Go ahead and give that.
We praise your name, Lord.
Thank you,
we
Lord.
Bless you. We glorify
Hallelujah,
you.
God.
We extol you. We worship you. We
Lord,
praise
we
you.
God.
We elevate you. Lord.
Hallelujah, God.
Hallelujah.
Your name is worthy to be praised.
You are worthy, oh God.
God, we bless you.
We bless
Lord.
Your
we
name,
bless
Lord
your
God.
Holy name.
We thank
God,
you.
We
thank
glorify
you.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
We
Lord,
appreciate
we thank you, God. Thank you for
you
what
are good
done.
Always, even
Hallelujah,
to the end
God.
Of the age.
There is no one like you.
There is no one like you.
Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus.
God,
we bless your name, Lord.
We bless your,
we bless
name,
your name, Jesus.
Father, you are holy.
Hallelujah,
you are excellent
God.
In all of your
we
ways.
Welcome you in this place right
welcome
now, God.
God.
We welcome you in our
thank
atmosphere,
you,
God. You are worthy,
you
God.
Worthy.
Move how you want to,
move,
God.
Oh God.
In,
God.
The
in
the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
We glorify you. We
thank you, Jesus.
You
thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Well, good evening.
Good
evening.
Evening.
I'm Reverend Joseph McLeod, and this is my lovely wife, Tanya.
Hey, y'all. Good evening. And welcome to Healing Fire Deliverance Ministries. Amen.
Amen. And we welcome you to our weekly Bible study. Mm-hmm. We're excited about what God has given us. We pray and hope that this word would be a rhema word,
yes.
A word that breaks yokes. A word that gives you instruction and encouragement. And so we are so godly excited. And today's topic, as a matter of fact, will be on the subject of forgiveness.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to be talking about forgiveness. And this is a Bible study, so we encourage you to go ahead
mm-hmm.
and get your Bible. We want for you to participate, join in right with us,
yes.
read along the scriptures,
yes.
and it will do you well. It will mm-hmm. bless you. And so before we actually get into the Word of God, we're going to first open with the word of prayer. So, honey, could you lead us in a word of prayer?
Father God, we thank you tonight, God, that we're able to come and just meditate on your word.
Yes, ma'am.
God, we thank you for allowing us to just embrace your word. God,
thank
tonight
you,
I ask that you would even give us more revelation, God, that
yes.
you would give us other practical application of your word, God.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, that you would even allow your word in us and those that are watching to be time released, God,
yes.
when they need it the most.
Mm-hmm.
God, when we need it the most, that we can draw from the word of God
yes.
hidden in our hearts. God, we pray that by your word we are convicted, we We are changed. We are transformed.
Yes.
We are regenerated in our minds, and we are renewed.
Yes.
We welcome you, Holy Spirit.
Welcome,
have
welcome.
Your way,
have
God.
Your will,
move
God.
Even through the live video tonight, God. Move in our atmosphere, God.
Yes.
We welcome you, God.
We welcome you.
Let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Let us decrease
yes,
that you would increase even the
thank
more.
You, Jesus.
And Father, I ask that you enlarge all of our capacities to receive more of your presence,
more of your,
of your word. Give us all a more longing desire to just seek your face
yes,
like
Lord
never
God.
Before
yes,
in these times. In Jesus' name we pray. Bless every family, every loved one represented
now,
that's watching, that's hearing this Bible study tonight. It's in Jesus' name.
In the name
amen.
Of Jesus.
Amen. And bless the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Praise
yes.
God. Well, I have a question to ask the audience, those who are tuning in. And I want you to think about this. Have you ever met someone that when they get offended, they hold on to that offense for a long time? And when someone does that, we say they hold on to a grudge.
Mm-hmm.
And have you ever met someone, you may know someone personally, it may hit home.
Yeah.
That,
ouch, amen.
That they get offended and they hold on to that offense for a day. Some hold on for a week, some a month, some for months, some for years, and some, unfortunately, honey, for a lifetime. And that's a problem. You see, God encourages us to forgive, and that's what we're talking about today. And it also reminds me of a time when I was much younger, and I worked in a place, and I had a supervisor who had recovered from cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And I, you know, at toward the end of my time at that place of employment, I can recall having a dream.
Mm-hmm.
God gave me a very unusual, but I believe yet prophetic dream.
Mm-hmm.
And what the Lord showed me in the dream was I came to work and I walked down the hall and I walked to that supervisor's office. And when I entered into her office, she was laying in her office on her deathbed. Her office actually became like a hospital room, and she was laying on her deathbed.
Mm-hmm.
And I woke up and didn't quite understand what it meant. But later on, now in real life, I go back to work and we get the news that the cancer that she had recovered from had come back.
Mm-hmm.
And things happened pretty rapidly. And a couple of weeks after that, she passed away.
Mm-hmm.
And God showed me during that period of time that there was, unfortunately, some bitterness. He gave me a revelation that there was some bitterness that was harbored that had not been resolved that caused this cancer to come back and to take her life. And so it behooves us to know why and how and who and when and how many times we need to forgive. So that's what we're going to be talking about
amen,
today.
Amen.
And I've entitled this message, Set Them Free So You Can Be Free.
Yes.
Set Them Free. So you can be free.
Yes.
And we're going to be reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 18, verse 23. And we're going to be reading the verse 35. And if you would, turn in your Bible to that chapter.
Amen.
And we will use that scripture today as our primary text.
Amen.
About the subject.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. So, honey, could you read
absolutely.
That for us?
Therefore, I'm sorry, pardon me. 23rd, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who wanted to settle accounts with his servants.
Yes.
As he began the settlement, a man who owed him 10,000 talents was brought to him. Since he was not able to pay, the master ordered that he and his wife and his children and all that he had be sold to repay the debt.
Wow.
The servant fell on his knees before him.
Hmm.
Be patient with me, he begged, and I will pay back everything. The servant's master took pity on him, canceled the debt, and let him go.
Amen.
But when that servant went out, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him 100 denarii. He grabbed him and began to choke him. Mm. "Pay back what you owe me," he demanded. His fellow servant fell to his knees and begged him, "Be patient with me and I will pay you back." But he refused. Instead, he went off and had the man thrown into prison until he could pay the debt. When the other servants saw what happened, they were greatly distressed and went and told their master everything that had happened. Then the master called the servant in. "You wicked servant," he said, "I canceled all that debt of yours because you begged me to. Shouldn't you have had mercy on your fellow servant just as I had on you?" In anger, his master turned him over to the jailers to be tortured until he should pay back all owed. This is how my heavenly Father will treat each of you unless you forgive your brother from your heart. And that's reading from the NIV version.
Amen. 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 So we thank God for the hearing and the reading of his yes. word. So here we see a serious scenario, a serious situation. It just reminds me again of our title, Set Them Free So That You Can Be Free. We're talking about forgiveness for those who are just joining us. And we're going to talk about what exactly is forgiveness. Many people may have some ideas, but forgiveness, as we can even see in the text, is it comes to a point after you've been offended that you stop requiring payment for a thing. You stop requiring payment for a thing. You cancel a debt. That's what forgiveness is, to cancel a debt. It also means to stop feeling angry or resentful towards someone or some circumstance that has offended you, that has hurt you, or that was a mistake.
Right.
You forgive. And you see, God requires that all of us forgive.
Right.
And see, there are some challenges when we decide not to forgive. Because sometimes what can happen is if we hold on to forgiveness, it's called unforgiveness, and if it begins to grow inside of us, it has the tendency and the potential to become bitterness. So unforgiveness over a period of time can become bitterness. That's very, very dangerous. And so bitterness is very poisonous.
Yes, it is.
Anger and unforgiveness is very poisonous.
Yes, it is.
And someone who is bitter and angry and unforgiving, it reminds me of a scenario that I've heard others talk about. It's almost as if there is an enemy that you have and you take poison and you ingest the poison expecting that your enemy die. That sounds crazy.
Yeah, really.
You yourself will die. You yourself would make your own self sick. And see, that's exactly what unforgiveness and bitterness does. It's as if you were trying to punish your enemy by holding on to the bitterness, by holding on to the anger. But by holding on to it, it is like you ingesting poison.
Yes.
And see, God does not want that. That's not the will of God.
It's not.
And so bitterness, just so that we understand, it's a deep, lingering anger and resentment coupled with hatred. It's above and beyond just being upset or offended. It is a long-term resentment that is coupled with a state of hatred for the person or the thing that has offended you. That's bitter. And see, that's a very toxic thing that can be extremely, extremely harmful. And so why do we need to forgive? It's very important. When we look at the text, we see here that it talks about, in verse 35, it says, "This is how my heavenly Father will treat each of you unless you forgive your brother from your heart." You see, God is requiring, first and foremost, that we forgive. The Bible also shows, even in the Lord's Prayer, "Lord, forgive us as we forgive
yes.
our debtors."
Yes.
And you see, God is requiring that we forgive so that he can forgive us. Keep this in mind, saints. Forgiveness from us is a prerequisite that God put in place in order for him to forgive us.
Yes, yes.
We need to cancel the debt of others so that our debts can be canceled.
Yes, God.
And we can see the problem that happened in the scriptures, where here was a man who had a huge debt that he could not pay. And he owed this king. And he cried and begged for mercy. And that king had mercy on him.
Yes.
He could have not only lost his own liberty, he would have been enslaved to pay off the debt to the king. But not only him, but his entire family.
Yes.
His wife, his children, he could have lost it all.
Yes.
And so he came to this king and he pled and he begged and the king forgave him.
I know.
He said, I will cancel your debt. Now that was an awesome day for that man.
Right, right.
Now you think that's what they call a jubilee.
I mean, your
debts are canceled.
Like
all that you owed, and you thought that you were about to lose it all.
Right.
And because you came to a king
who
was merciful and who was kind.
That's right.
He could have justly threw the man in prison, but he extended mercy and extended grace. Mm-hmm. Now, let me just say something about mercy. Mercy, different from grace, is God, for example, withholding the full blood of punishment that you and I deserve. That's mercy.
Thank God for mercy.
Amen. Thank God for mercy. Mm-hmm. You see, the king withheld the punishment that this man deserved.
Yes, he did.
He gave him mercy.
He did.
And he extended grace. He gave him freedom. He allowed him to go.
And his children and his wife.
That's right, honey.
His family. He allowed his family
to
also be free as a consequence of his mercy toward him.
Toward him. And that's amazing.
It is.
And just think about how often and how many times we need forgiveness from God.
Mm-hmm.
We've done some heinous crimes.
Mm-hmm.
We've done some things where we really messed up.
Mm-hmm.
And we needed to come before God.
Yes.
And we expected and prayed and pleaded and asked God to forgive us and extend us his mercy and his grace.
Yes.
Now watch this in the scripture. The same man who was forgiven, the same man who at that moment was praising God, excited and glad.
Mm-hmm.
You see, the news about this went all over the land. They knew that this man was due to be in prison, him and his family, but the king let him off and let him go free. Everybody knew about it. That man went back home, and now he's walking around. And I get the sense that he had a little air about him, almost pride. Well, another person came to him who owed him far less than what he owed the king. Maybe equivalent of a $10 bill compared to $1 million,
right,
if you think about it.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what he did? He grabbed this man by the collar, by the neck, and said, if you don't pay me back my money, I will throw you in jail. This is what this man's response was. You see, he used his rights, but did not extend grace.
Mm-hmm.
You see, something about grace, which is amazing. God has the right to exact judgment.
Hallelujah.
But because of his love, he extends grace
and
he extends mercy.
Yes, he does.
He doesn't exact what we deserve. But this man, he said, I'm going to use my right. I'm going to punish you because you owe me money that you had not paid me back. Well, all of the community heard what happened and they were distraught. They were angry and they went back and they told the king what happened. And the king said, that evil and wicked servant, bring him back here. And what he did, he said, after all that I did for you, he was basically saying, you could not extend that to someone who owed you far less. And then he punished the man. And then he was tortured. And he said that he will have to pay every last cent. You see, God is that king. And we are like the man who owed the king. God forgives us. But then he says, I require you to forgive anybody who ever offends you.
Right.
In the scope and the scheme of things,
it
would be like you owing me, God says, $1 million, and then someone owes you $10 and you don't forgive them. God said, I can't work with that. You have to forgive. It's a prerequisite. The other reason why we need to forgive, and this is very important, the Bible says, if we look at Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26. And even before we read that, I just want to make note that when a person is offended, we react and we respond in many ways. Mm-hmm. One of the key reactions is anger. When you've been offended and when you feel that some injustice has occurred against you, we get angry. Mm-hmm. And you see, sometimes to be angry is not a bad thing. Mm-hmm. But the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 4, actually verse 25, be angry but sin not. Mm-hmm. And then in verse 26 it goes on. It goes on and it says, do not let the sun go down on your anger. Or do not let the sun go down while you are still angry. And then it says, do not give the devil a foothold.
Can I just interject?
Yes, you can, honey.
I just want to say something about the wicked servant who mm-hmm. roughed up the man. Mm-hmm. It's amazing, too, because when we're harboring unforgiveness,
yes,
we murder people or assault them with our mouths. Mm-hmm. We slander their names in the streets mm-hmm. or on social media, mm-hmm. subliminal, whatever mm-hmm. it is. Mm-hmm. And there's someone watching. Mm-hmm. So the other servants were watching this man.
Yeah.
Basically assault him physically.
Wow.
But then here, as we are today, uh-huh. not only do people still assault people physically, mm-hmm. but unfortunately, even we as believers mm-hmm. or in those who are not, but especially we as believers in the body of Christ, we still assault people verbally, and wow. someone is watching, mm-hmm. and maybe perhaps they're praying for you, saying, mm-hmm. God, I just saw Pastor so-and-so or Sister so-and-so mm-hmm. or Brother so-and-so say something that wasn't so kind,
yeah.
and maybe they haven't ought with them, but you know what? I see what they're doing. Mm. I'm asking you, God,
yeah.
convict them.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? So it's important to how our code of conduct is mm. biblically,
yes.
because he's saying, God is saying, you should have done so-and-so just like I forgave you.
Yes.
So our code of conduct and our behavior mm-hmm. when we're slandering someone with our mouths mm-hmm. because we have an ought against them, mm-hmm. because we don't forgive them, we have to be careful. Number one, God is watching.
Yes,
that's
yes.
number one. And number two, there's an onlooker
mm-hmm.
who's watching your character,
mm-hmm.
who is watching your code of biblical conduct.
Mm-hmm.
And we have this conduct, the code of conduct that we must follow.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen. Okay. Amen. Wow. Praise God. And so here it is. God is saying, don't allow your anger to go down with the sun.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be angry. Other versions of that same scripture says, don't be angry all day long until the sun goes down. So there's a level where God is saying, you know what? It's not just waiting until the sun goes down. God is encouraging us, don't be angry long time. Deal with the situation immediately. Resolve that offense. Don't allow it to go on and on and on, because the longer you wait, the worse it gets. And even worse than that, if the sun goes down and you are still angry, worse than that, you go to sleep while angry and you wake up the next morning, mm-hmm. guess what? You're still angry. And it's worse.
Mm-hmm.
The worst condition is this. The enemy was waiting the whole time. The Bible says when you do that, you give the enemy a foothold. And that's dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
And so then I asked the Lord, well, what is a foothold?
Mm-hmm.
And I looked and I want to share with you this evening, saints, what a foothold is.
Mm-hmm.
And it's amazing because a foothold is a strong position where one places their feet
mm-hmm.
in order to make an advancement, especially when climbing.
Mm-hmm.
Another definition is a position usable as a base for further advance. A place where you can put your feet. And now watch this. A situation where someone gains power or influence needed to get what they want.
Wow.
Now, think about it.
Wow.
With climbers, just to paint this picture, when climbers are climbing, let's say, a wall or a mountain, they often find places in the rock where they can insert their foot,
mm-hmm.
and that is considered a foothold. And it allows them to advance higher up the mountain. It's a foothold. Now, get this. When you hold on to anger and you don't release it through forgiveness, the devil makes you that foothold. And guess what? His foot is on top of you. You are under his foot.
And he's not, we're supposed to have him under our feet.
Amen.
But he has his foot on us and we're under him.
Yes.
Because we gave him a foot.
Yes. So we're under his foot. We're under now his influence so that he can advance against us. And you see, what is the enemy trying to do? The word says the devil comes only to kill and to steal and to destroy.
Right.
You see, he's trying to make an advance so that he can fulfill his purpose, which is to steal from you and to kill you, to take away anything godly that God wants for you to have. He's advancing against you when you harbor or hold on to anger. He's waiting for you not to let it go. He wants you to hold a grudge. It gives him an advantage. Now, watch this. When we hold on to a grudge, when we hold on to anger,
right,
and it gives way to a foothold, any foothold unchecked, the enemy can then use to create a stronghold.
Yes.
Now, a stronghold is a worse condition. A stronghold now is when he's entered into your mind to the extent where even how you perceive or even how you think is based on his demonic influence. And it's like torture. It's like him now entering into your life and he torments you with these reoccurring negative thoughts. And it puts you in a state of bondage. You see, the enemy is after your freedom. He wants to imprison you. And you see, whenever we don't forgive, it gives room and access of those demon spirits to come and assault you. How can we see that also in the Word? Well, let's look at this story here, because the story reveals a spiritual truth. If we look at it and we go down to verse 32, and just to recap, it says, then the master called the servant in and he said, you wicked servant. He said, I canceled all that debt of yours because you begged me to. Verse 33 says, shouldn't you have had mercy on your fellow servant just as I had on you? Now, check this out. Verse 34, in anger, his master turned him over to the jailers to what? To be tortured until he should pay back all he owed. To be tortured. The real life scenario is this. If you don't forgive, the enemy will take advantage of that. He will get a foothold, especially if that forgiveness is unresolved and the sun goes down on it. He will get an advantage over you. But then the following thing is this. There will be demons that will torment and torture you about that very offense, because the adversary is trying to take over your soul. Understand this about the necessity of forgiveness. You see, forgiveness allows us to process an injustice, to process a wrong, to process an offense in a positive way. But you know what, honey? If we don't process those offenses in a positive way and we harbor it, it becomes toxic inside of us. It's a toxic thing that's inside of us.
Right.
Just like bitterness that we spoke of earlier. And now, if you think about the damaging effect of, of toxicity, honey, what are some of the damaging effects, would you say?
I mean, it's almost as if your bloodstream has been poisoned somehow by some toxic waste in your bloodstream, which is traveling out through every organ of your body. So in essence, eventually, unchecked, every organ in your body will begin to shut down because you yourself, you are being poisoned and your bloodstream is poisoned. So we should make sure that we expel. In fact, that what came to me was resist the enemy and he will flee. So when I was, when I was in discussion, resisting the enemy so that he can flee because of the stronghold, we know the foundation of that is lies because of unforgiveness. So when we resist the enemy and we forgive, he will flee from what has been done to us externally, but he will flee from us internally, and he doesn't have a foothold, a stronghold, a peephole. He has no holes. There's nothing in him nothing in me that the enemy can find to use me to accuse my brother or my sister or even to accuse God. God will allow the enemy to flee from my mind, from my thinking, from my emotions. I release the negativity. I release this because I reject the enemy. I resist him, and I renounce everything that came to try and give me an offense. I release that offense, and I forgive. And we know that forgiveness is a process, but from our heart, God is just asking, just say, I forgive them.
Yes.
And then we release the negativity, because it's the negativity that produces that toxicity to poison us internally, and then we have a stronghold.
Wow.
So resist the enemy, and he will flee, not just out of my mind, but he will flee from even me seeing things, or even if someone did me wrong, and whatever. It's those external and the internal things. The enemy has to flee, and then he's under our feet. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. And you see, that's where we want to keep the enemy. And you know, this just brings to light, or brings to mind, that forgiveness is actually a weapon of warfare. You see,
speak,
I never really thought about that before.
Speak on it.
Forgiveness is a weapon. Not necessarily against the one who hurt you.
Yes.
Not that type of weapon. But it's a weapon against the very devil, the very enemy of God, the very enemy of our soul that would try to destroy us and our family. It's a weapon. And it keeps us free and clear of the toxicity that the enemy wants to build up inside of us that would kill us. It keeps us free and clear of any type of foothold, of any type of stronghold that would give entryway for any demon to come inside of us and torment us. It protects us. Forgiveness is a weapon.
It's a protection.
It's to protect us. Amen.
Amen. That's awesome.
And so forgiveness ultimately is to set you free. And it reminds me and my wife, we saw this movie, and briefly, this movie, there was a lady who had her daughter murdered in a way that was unthinkable.
Oh, her daughter was murdered.
Her daughter
and
was murdered.
And the mother was a police officer, but she found out, she got the news that her daughter had been murdered.
Yes, okay. And she got this news, and then she began to investigate. She was a police officer. She located the man who murdered her daughter. And you would think that that man lost his life, but they couldn't find him all of a sudden. Well, toward the end of the movie, it turned out that this lady who was a police officer captured this man, put him in an old cell.
In her basement.
In her basement. An old cell. And so there were times every day when she would torture him, when she would barely feed him. And at the end of the movie, he had been in such bad shape that he looked like an animal. His hair had grown beyond the point of him looking like a human.
His nails were like claws.
And he and the reason why he was in that condition was because the woman carried bitterness. She wouldn't let him go.
Right. She wouldn't let it go.
And she wouldn't let him die. You see, she was in bondage.
Because
and
she
began
let him go.
She began to lose her mind and lose her facilities. And it got to a point where the other fellow police officers wanted to know what was wrong with her.
Right.
She would go home and they didn't know where she was, but then they discovered that she had kidnapped the man who committed the crime and was holding him hostage. But in effect, she was also in that same prison. You see, that's what bitterness and unforgiveness does. It puts you in the same prison that you are
trying to put others in.
Put others in. When you harbor resentment, when you don't let it go, you put yourself in that same prison. Now watch this. The interesting thing was, she didn't kill the man. She fed him just enough to survive, to keep him alive.
Speak on it.
And you see, sometimes we keep that offense just enough to stay alive. We don't ever kill it. We keep it alive by feeding it. And so, honey, what are some of the ways in which we can keep those things alive?
You just replay it in your mind, and every time you see them, you pick up that offense or that unforgiveness again, and you keep giving aid to it. Don't give aid to it in your mind, in your emotions, and by verbally assaulting them. Don't give aid. She didn't starve him to let him die. She kept feeding him food. But in the spiritual, because we always try and find a moral of a story when we're watching something as to how it even relates to today.
Yes.
But what it is we don't want to continue to give aid to an offense or give aid to unforgiveness, because that then ties into the foothold. The foothold grows to a stronghold. A stronghold, you're just clink, you're bound. And that same woman, and just like many of those or many of us who at some point in time can refuse to release unforgiveness for whatever reasons, that means that you're feeding it and you have to release it because you're now toxic.
Yes.
You don't want to be toxic.
No, you don't.
Right? We don't want to be toxic. We don't want to feed it. We want to release those negative emotions.
That's right.
We want to starve them to death.
Starve it to death.
We want to starve them to death.
Yes.
And we want to eat the bread of life that gives us food, that gives us nutrients, that cleanses our blood.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So forgiveness is to set you free.
Yes.
It is a prerequisite of God. It is a weapon to protect you against the enemy, but it's to set you free.
Yes.
That's the why. It's necessary for us to forgive. It's a healthy thing to do.
Mm-hmm.
How often should you do it? Well, we look and we see even in Matthew chapter 17, the disciples asked Jesus that question, how often do I need to forgive? Seven times, 70 times? And Jesus said 70 times seven. Well, his point was not necessarily 70 times seven and you do the multiplication and you come up with the number and you say, okay, I've done it that many times. But Jesus was making the point, you need to forgive as much as necessary. In other words, every time you are offended, you need to respond with forgiveness. Okay, so you forgive when it happens, and then you forgive when it reoccurs. What do I mean by that?
Mm-hmm.
The reoccurrence of an offense happens in your mind when you think about it over and over again. And you see, sometimes it's not you who brings it back to your mind. Sometimes it's the enemy projecting a thought into your head using your own voice to cause you to think it's just you thinking about it all over again.
Mm-hmm.
But really the enemy is trying to bait you into thinking,
into
rehearsing, into nursing the same hurt all over again to get you into bondage.
Mm-hmm.
He's trying to get you into bondage.
Mm-hmm.
And so, like we said, as a defense and as a weapon, when it reoccurs in your mind,
yes,
forgive again.
Yes, and resist the enemy.
And resist the enemy. Yes,
and he will flee from you.
And he will flee. Continue to extend forgiveness.
Mm-hmm.
But you want to also forgive until that emotion goes away.
Yes.
Just don't forgive from your head. The word says you need to forgive from your heart.
Yes.
You need to forgive from your heart.
Yes.
And now who do we need to forgive? Of course we need to forgive the person who offended us. But you know what else is very interesting? And I'm going to say this. You need to forgive yourself. You need to forgive yourself. My sister, my brother, it's not your fault.
Mm-hmm.
It's not your fault that that happened.
Mm-hmm.
Let yourself off the hook. You need to let yourself go.
Mm-hmm.
See, the devil comes to condemn you. You have to let yourself go.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't your fault. You have to forgive yourself. So you forgive the person who committed the crime, but you have to forgive yourself. Take time to ask God to help you to let yourself off the hook. You have to forgive yourself. It's critical. You also, believe it or not, may need to forgive God. You see, sometimes when things happen, an injustice occurred, we ask this question, God, why did you let that happen to me or my loved one?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm hurt and I'm angry, not just at them, but I'm angry at you for not stopping it. And you see, sometimes we don't understand all of the whys behind what occurred in our life. Because we live in a fallen world, things happen both to the righteous and the unrighteous.
Yes.
But God is still good.
He's still good.
And so if you're in that place, and you feel some type of way even against God who loves you
very much,
you have to even address the area that I also may need to release God himself.
Mm-hmm. And be honest that you may have an ought with God because the enemy will accuse God to us.
Yes.
So we have to understand that it's important to dissect this thing, the matters of the heart. It's important to do that. It's important to understand what parts of our hearts are wounded and what parts of our hearts have an accusation.
Mm.
And the enemy is the accuser of the brethren.
Yes, he is.
And so he will accuse God to us. And we know that God loves us so much that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not even perish, but have everlasting life. I don't know about you, but for someone who wants to give me everlasting life,
yes,
has to love me beyond measure.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. So we need to forgive.
Yes.
Sometimes you may not even realize it. Mm-hmm. And this is a topic that we may address at another time. But sometimes we may even need to forgive our ancestors. Those that we don't even know, who may have committed certain things, who have had certain tendencies that caused us in some way to make a mistake. What I mean by that.
Not placing blame, but just understanding the operation of what's going on in the realm of the spirit. Amen.
That's right. And you see, there's a scripture that talks about the sins of the fathers goes down to the third and fourth generation. And sometimes there is what is called a generational curse or a generational sin. And then we have a predisposition or an inclination to do a specific thing that's contrary to the will and purpose of God that ultimately is harmful to us. And when we recognize that, we even have to forgive at some point our ancestors, forgive our parents and our great-grandparents. But it's important, brothers and sisters, that you realize you have to forgive those who have offended you. You have to let yourself off the hook. You have to forgive yourself. You have to forgive God because he loves you. Amen?
Amen.
So when we forgive, finally, when we forgive, it's very important that we pray to God and we say, God, you know what? I need your help.
Yes.
And you see, we didn't say it was easy. It may be very difficult. And you see, God never requires you to do something without giving you the strength and the power and the equipment to do it. You see, God will help you. This is scripture found in Romans 5:5. And it says, God has given you his love. It's shed abroad in your heart. And you see, when you go before God to forgive, you say, I will forgive and I will release.
Yes, yes.
As an act of my will, as an act of my will, and with your help, God, by the shed love of God in my heart by way of the Holy Spirit. You see, the Holy Spirit will give you the ability to do a thing that you can't do in and of yourself.
Yes.
It's difficult, saints. We're not saying it's easy because some of us have been through some hard things. We're not just saying it's a walk in the park, but God understands it, and he's not leaving you alone to do it.
Right.
He will take your hand, and he will walk you through it.
Mm-hmm. Amen. And because forgiveness is a process,
yes,
he walks with us in the process.
Amen.
If we let him.
If we let
so
him.
That's part of it. We're not saying forgiveness is overnight. Forgiveness, the act itself by faith, is done from the heart overnight. But the process, when the enemy tries to come and speak to you and accuse God or the person or even accuse you to yourself,
yes,
it's a process
it
if
a
we
process.
Let the Lord in it, and he is more than willing to be in this process,
yes,
with us. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So we encourage you again,
yes,
set them free.
Set them free.
So you can be free.
So you can be free.
Amen.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Bless glory to God. Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise
Jesus.
God.
Jesus. Thank you,
Amen.
God. Thank you, God.
Well, some of you, you may have heard this word, and you may say, I need forgiveness. There are things that I have done that have disqualified me for salvation. And I need to get right with you, God. And some of you also may say, I've been hurt and I've been wounded and I need help. I need someone to pray with me so that I have the strength given to me by God to let my offenders go. We want to pray those two prayers. So we first are going to pray a prayer of salvation for anyone listening.
Yes.
And maybe you've been offended. Maybe you've been hurt. Maybe you've held on to bitterness. And the enemy has been tormenting you. And you can't sleep. You have sickness in your body.
Mm.
And you know what, as a matter of fact, honey,
Jesus,
we've learned that some sicknesses is related to
unforgiveness.
It's a mental dis-ease that causes and produces a physical dis-ease.
Mm-hmm. And a soul dis-ease.
And a soul disease. You see, God wants to set you free today.
Set us free, Jesus.
And so we're going to pray two prayers.
Hallelujah.
And so if you would, if you
Hallelujah,
bow
your
head, close your eyes.
Hallelujah,
and we're
going to
have a
Jesus.
Prayer of salvation.
Hallelujah.
Just repeat after us. Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I come before you now.
I come before you now.
And I admit.
And I admit.
That I need forgiveness.
That I need forgiveness.
I admit.
I admit.
And I confess.
And I confess.
That I have sinned.
That I have sinned.
And Lord,
I am sorry
for offending you,
for offending,
and for hurting others,
and for hurting others.
And right now, God, I repent.
I repent.
I turn.
I turn.
From my old evil way of life.
From my old evil way of life.
And I now, God.
And I now, God.
Turn to you.
Turn to you.
And Father.
Father.
I ask you.
I ask you.
To have mercy on me.
To have mercy on me.
And to forgive me.
And to forgive me.
Of all of my sins.
Of all of my sins.
And now, God.
God.
I open up my heart.
I open my heart.
And I open up my life.
And I open my life.
And I invite you in Jesus,
you in Jesus
as my Lord,
as my Lord,
and as my Savior,
and as my Savior,
in Jesus' name,
in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
Glory be to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory be to God.
And if you prayed that prayer,
yes,
for the first time from your heart,
from your heart,
God knows it, and you have become one of His, mm-hmm, and now you are on the journey to be set free from all of the areas where you have sinned. From all of the areas where you have missed the mark and have offended others.
Mm-hmm.
But He's also going to set you free, mm-hmm, from the bondages that others have put on you,
mm-hmm,
by offense.
Mm-hmm.
God has given you and will continue to strengthen you that you would forgive. And so we're going to quickly pray this last prayer.
Yes.
That anyone who's struggling with a matter,
mm-hmm,
who's been hurt, who's been wounded,
yes,
it could be a long-term thing. We want to pray your strength.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. And right now, God,
right now,
we come before you,
yes,
as your children.
God,
and Father God, we intercede,
yes, God, in Jesus,
and we pray for our brothers and our sisters listening,
God,
to us now. Lord God, who've been hurt, who've been offended, who've been wounded, oh God. It could be over years. It could be in a day. It could be over months. Lord God, we pray that you would, by your Spirit, give them your grace. Give them your love. Your word says that the Spirit of God has shed abroad your love into our hearts. Lord God, open the eyes of their understanding that they would realize that your love is in them, that they can partner with you to forgive and cause them to will and to do. Lord God, to release and to forgive those who have offended them, that they would be free. And God, we pray, God, that you would cause them as an act of their will to release and to forgive those who have offended them.
Hallelujah.
To release and to forgive themselves.
Release and forgive.
To release and to forgive even you, oh God,
in
the name of Jesus.
Strengthen
them now, God. Set them free now, God. Bring them out of the bondage that they've been in, Lord God. Set them free from the tormentors, God, that they would have shalom, that they would have peace. Set them free now,
God.
Allow them to forgive in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord God.
We pray.
Yes.
Amen.
God, amen.
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 Praise
amen.
God.
Amen. It is so. It is
so.
We believe by faith exactly what we're praying.
Yes.
We stand in the gap. We pray from our heart.
Mm-hmm.
And we believe God, not even wavering. We know that God can do anything but fail. So
yes,
He can release everything from you that is not of Him, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We bless you in the city. We bless,
yes,
you in the name of the Lord. We bless you in the field.
Yes.
You are blessed in your mind. You're blessed in your body.
Yes.
You are blessed in your finances. You're blessed when you come and when you go. You are blessed in your down city. You are blessed in your uprising.
Yes.
Your family is blessed.
Family's
your
blessed.
Seed is blessed.
Yes.
Everything you touch is blessed. Every place you are, we declare blessings upon blessings over your life in the name,
of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. And amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. We thank you for joining our Bible study,
yes,
here at Healing Fire Deliverance Ministries. For those who don't know, again, this is God has blessed us and allowed, mm-hmm, us to launch this ministry that has been in preparation for a time.
Yes.
And God has released us and released this ministry forth in this season.
Mm-hmm.
We do have Thursday intercessory prayer at 7:30 here live on Facebook. Also, you are able to go to our website at www.hfdministries.org. I found that right there.
Amen.
Okay. Or you can visit our page here live at Facebook, Healing Fire Deliverance Ministries. Please also understand that you can also send us your prayer requests.
Yes, you can.
Even though we have intercessory prayer on Thursdays, you can send us your prayer requests or at any time. We have our conference call, mm-hmm, along with the live intercessory prayer at that time as well. So we bless you in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Have a wonderful evening.
Have a wonderful evening.
Amen.